Hello, my name is Mohammed. I'm a citizen of Australia with the Iranian background. Right now we are here on the anniversary of the International Human Rights Day, which is a very important day for all the human beings, especially for people of Iran whose rights suffering under the dictatorship of the Iranian mullahs for more than 3 decades now. So the first and most objective that we got against the Iranian regime is violation of human rights. Up to now, over 120,000 of Iranian young generation been executed by this brutal regime. In summer of 1988, in matter of the month, over 30,000 Iranian political prisoners been massacred. And unfortunately, still the international community taking silence regarding to that matter. Stoning, public hanging, amputation of legs and hands and finger is a practical punishment of this regime since they came to power in February 1979. More than 450 terrorist activities and operations this regime committed out of Iran. And also every single year over 80,000 Iranian youth been subjected to arrest, punishment and detention. This is a brief about what's happening inside Iran, and a part of it, as you well know, the student movement, the worker union movement, all of these particular social movement been suppressed by the regime as well. Right now, in the era of the International Human Rights Day, we also would like to mention the situation of 3,400 Iranian refugees living in the camp inside Iraq called Camp Ashraf. These Iranian refugees been classified as a protected person by the multinational forces in 2004, when after the invasion of Iraq. Unfortunately, in 2009, the protection of these refugees been handed over to the Iraqi government. And in two different occasions, the Iraqi government launched a deadly attack on the residents inside the camp. And as a result of these two deadly attacks, over 47 these Iranian refugees, including men and women, been killed, and more than 1,000 of them are badly wounded. Recently, we have been informed that the Iraqi government, under the leader of the Nouri al-Maliki, the prime minister, set out a deadline for these refugees to leave Iraq. So this is violation of the international humanitarian law. This is in violation of the 4 Geneva Convention, and this is a violation of all international humanitarian norms. Therefore, we're calling on the international community, we're urging the United Nations Security Council, the EU and the Australian government to intervene with the issue and stop another massacre take place in this camp inside Iraq. The people of Ashraf, the residents of Camp Ashraf are symbol of the Iranian resistance against the dictatorship of mullahs inside Iran. We as Iranian, part of the Iranian community in Australia, will stand for the right of these people and will call on our government to do the best to save the life of these people before we've seen another bloodshed in this camp. And thank you so much, and I hope my voice gets to somewhere.